Well guys, it has finally happened. I managed to get my hands on the most popular gaming CPU from AMD, the Ryzen 5 5600X. Mind you, I only had it for like a day to play with, because it was borrowed to me by a friend, but at least we have everything we need to know in the Dan A4 SFX case on the Asetek 645LT all-in-one cooler. So, let's begin. As you know, these new chips are very hard to get at retail prices, so I decided to wait it out until I can get one at a fair price. Luckily, a friend upgraded his computer and he kindly borrowed it to me so I can do this video for you guys. Thus, a big shout out to Angelo for this CPU. You all know by now how capable this 6-core 5600X is, even in stock form, so yeah, let's not waste any more time and jump straight into the results. I will compare it to my current Ryzen 3 3100 quad-core CPU, and of course we are even more interested in the thermals in the Dan A4 SFX case with the AIO cooler. The full system specs are in the description, and how I set up my Dan A4 SFX aka Ryzen Judge 3.0, you can see it here. I will test the CPU in stock form and then I'll do a manual overclock like I did with my previous 3700X, where I got great results from this procedure, as in keeping the overall stock performance but dropping over 20 degrees Celsius from the temperatures. As we know, this is a really big deal in the Dan A4 SFX case. Let's start with the temps with the Ryzen 3 to get a baseline, and then I will show you the results for the 5600X, and don't worry, I will group all the results at the end. Now here is the 5600X in stock form in the same testing scenarios, and all of these tests are done of course with a side panel on. The recorded ambient temperature was 20 degrees Celsius. From what I understand from other reviews, and of course I did test it myself, this 5600X is very good out of the box, that there is almost no point to further overclock it above what it already offers. Of course you can go higher, but I'm talking about a compact PC build perspective where CPU cooling is highly limited, like our precious Dan A4 SFX. Thus, this is why I decided to do my manual overclock for you guys, so you know what to expect. I have discovered that a 4GHz all-core manual OC at 1.1V will give you between 90-95% of its stock performance, as I am just showing you right now. Okay, now let's group our findings. This is one very fast CPU and a perfect upgrade to any AMD system, and I'm so happy to see these overall gains and especially the thermal results even in stock form. I am mentioning this because like the previous series, it likes to inject high voltage numbers on short bursts. Despite this, as you saw, even in stock form with the Asetek 645LT, we are around 70 degrees C in a full CPU stress test, which is epic. My manual OC is of course for those that will use it on air, like the Noctua L9A, that have builds even smaller than the Dan A4. The overall gains are really good with this voltage, that I saw anywhere between 6 to 11 degrees C, and even better in games where there will be no more spikes, at least in that Valhalla title. Right then, let's conclude the performance testing with some gaming benchmarks just for fun with the 5600X in stock form versus the Ryzen 3 also stock. As you may notice that the MSI Afterburner cannot display the extra info like temps and frequency as it does for my Ryzen 3 CPU. Apparently it's a very common problem, which I think it will be sorted in a later AMD chipset driver update and or a BIOS update. Mind you, this CPU, as you can see, is meant for the newer RTX series cards, where you will see even higher gains. Despite my aging GTS 1080 at 1080p resolution, I still saw a juicy increase in overall fluidity when compared to the Ryzen 3 in some of the games that I have benchmarked, besides the increase in key FPS numbers. Finally, here is a sound footprint for the whole computer with the 6 core in stock form with everything on stock RPM fan curves. So, there you have it guys, hopefully one day I can upgrade my CPU, but for now the 3100 still delivers at least for my needs. Of course the 5600X is a different beast and I'm so happy that I managed to play with it to bring this video to you guys that wanted to know how viable it is to be cooled in the DAN A4, and as you saw, the answer is a definitive yes. Thank you for watching guys, and how many of you have this CPU in the A4? Until the next one, Alex out.